Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV, YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys have not already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. In this video, I'll be doing a breed review of the Belgian Malanois. Let's first get into some facts about the breed. The Belgian Malanois is a breed that will live a long time and has a life expectancy of 12 to 14 years. In regards to the breed's temperament, it is known to be stubborn, alert, hardworking, active, friendly, confident, protective, and watchful. The breed is considered to be a medium to large sized dog. Males weigh between 55 and 66 pounds. Females are 49 to 55 pounds. In regards to height, females are 22 to 24 inches. Males are 24 to 26 inches. Historically speaking, the Belgian Malinois is a sheepdog and was originally used for herding. Malinois are a variety of the Belgian Shepherd dog, which comes in four different varieties. Malinois are identifiable from the other breeds by their short coat. Breed also comes in the colors of fawn, mahogany, and black. Today, the Malinois is used much less on the farm and much more so in military and police applications. Around the world, the Malinois is considered to be the elite dog breed when it comes to police and military work. If you're interested in bringing a Malinois into your pet home, there are a lot of things that I personally would take into consideration. First and foremost, Malinois today are really bred to be workers. Much of the breeding stock out there is for, like I said earlier, is used in police and military applications. These dogs can live in pet homes, but they require a lot of work. So some of the things that I would take into consideration before buying or considering a Malinois as a pet is, first and foremost, how much time do I have to provide to this dog in terms of physical and mental stimulation? This breed has a tremendous amount of drive and very high level of intelligence. Without the proper amount of stimulation, these dogs can become very destructive. Okay, so once you've reconciled the fact that you do have the time to own a Belgian Malinois, the next thing you want to take into consideration is, well, what exactly would you do? One of the great things about this breed is that they have a tremendous amount of energy and they're down to do almost anything that makes you happy. These dogs are runners, so if you're a trail runner, a Belgian Malinois is a great running partner. The breed does very well in protection work, police work, search and rescue, tracking, agility. With any of these activities though, my suggestion would be to make sure that you take it up a notch, meaning that the courses should provide the dog not only with physical obstacles, but maybe even mental obstacles. This is a very intelligent dog breed. They need to be mentally stimulated as well as physically stimulated. Now, I feel like I say this in all of my breed review videos, but there is a big difference between working and pet quality dogs, or show dogs, I guess I would say. That difference could be no more distinct than with the Belgian Malinois. Working Belgian Malinois, first of all, every Belgian Malinois is going to be extremely energized. You know, just think of your most energetic dog with an extra boost of energy. That's what Belgian Malinois typically are. Now, if you're talking about a working Belgian Malinois, may want to times that times 10. The level of focus, energy, and drive in a working Belgian Malinois is second to none. That is why specifically these dogs are used so much in military and police work. So my suggestion is, if you're going to look for a Belgian Malinois for a pet home, please go to a show breeder or someone who is specifically breeding Belgian Malinois for pet homes as companions. I'm not sure that you can find that, but if you can, that's what you want. I've done a video with a young lady who brought a working Malinois into her home. She made it work, but it was a lot of work. All right, guys, so I'm not one who recommends Belgian Malinois for pet homes, and I also do not recommend the breed for first-time dog owners. Not because the dog is dangerous or reckless in any way, but because this dog is so serious that any owner who is not as serious and focused and capable as a Belgian Malinois will probably run into a tremendous amount of problems. And like I said before, this breed can be destructive if not properly stimulated. All right, guys, so listen, if you guys are looking to get a Belgian Malinois and you have a working purpose for the breed, I encourage you to do your research, find a breeder who can provide you with the best dog for yourself and your family. All right, I'll talk to you guys on the next one. Peace. Your own style, I should slay for you, ain't got it though. Talking like you got it, that's a problem on my life.
let it go. Eenie, eenie, meenie, meenie, miney, mo. Head to toe. Said you got your own style, that's just slang for you. Ain't got it though. Talking like you got it, that's a